Hello everyone, welcome to the computer class. This is Poonam Srivastava. Today's video is about HTML. Nowadays, most of our work depends on net surfing. In search of information, we go to different websites. These websites are made up of web pages. But have you ever wondered how are these web pages created? I'll tell you. We use HTML to design these web pages. In this video, we will learn about introduction to HTML and its tags. Introduction to HTML. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It is used to create web pages, which includes text, graphics, hyperlinks, and other support media. It is a simple markup language that defines the structure, layout, and behavior of a web document. HTML allows you to mark up text. By using this, you can make your text more interactive and dynamic. Now, before designing web pages, we should also know the history of HTML. Earlier in 1980s, HTML began its journey as GML. GML stands for General Markup Language. After modification in 1986, it was named as SGML. SGML stands for Standard Generalized Markup Language. In 1989, it was redesigned by Tim Berners-Lee and his team and was named as HTML. The standard version of HTML 2.0 was released in 1995. After 2 years, HTML 3.0 was announced. Again, after 2 years, with some new features, HTML 4.0 was released. On 28th October 2014, HTML 5.0 was released. As HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language, it can be described as follows. Hypertext. Hypertext is a text used to link various web pages. It is the text on a web page which on clicking opens a new web page. Markup. HTML marks the text as a certain type and tells the browser how to display text, images, etc. in a web page. HTML is considered as a language as it has its own syntax and rules. Features of HTML. Easy to understand. HTML's syntax is not very difficult. Thus, it is very easy to understand. It is easy to modify also. If changes are required in HTML coding, we can make modifications very easily. Another feature of HTML is that it is not case sensitive. We can write syntax in both cases, upper or lower. Because of this, syntax errors are reduced. More flexible. It has a more flexible way to design web pages along with text. In HTML, graphics, sounds, videos, and links can be used and imported to give an attractive look to the web page. By using different formatting effects, we can create attractive web pages. One can display HTML document on any platform such as Windows, Unix, etc. We require two basic tools to work with HTML documents, HTML editor and web browser. We use HTML editor for creating HTML code, and after creating code, we save file with an extension .htm or .html. Now to view created web pages, we need a web browser. HTML editor. There are mainly two types of HTML editors. WYSIWYG editor. WYSIWYG stands for what you see is what you get. This type of web editor allows developer to see what the result will come while the document is being created. These editors provide various tools and graphical interfaces where the web pages are designed. For example, Dreamweaver. Text editor. We can use text editors like Notepad or WordPad for creating HTML documents. Browser. A web browser is a software which is used to view web pages or websites. For example, Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, etc. HTML code is made up of tags, elements, and attributes. Tags. It is a piece of code which acts as a label that a web browser interprets. It instructs the web browser what to display and how to display. Tags contain elements which define how the information on a web page is formatted or displayed. They contain text enclosed in angle brackets. Each tag has its own attributes and default values. Each tag in HTML has some specific rules known as syntax. For example, font tag. Attributes. An attribute provides additional information about any HTML tag. It is always specified inside the opening tag. All attributes consist of two parts, a name and a value. Attribute value is always enclosed within double quotes. For example, body bg color is equal to blue. Here you can see bg color is an attribute of body tag. Bg color is the name of the attribute and blue is the value of the attribute. The HTML elements can be categorized as container elements and empty elements. Container elements. In HTML, the tags that include both on and off tags are called container elements. On tag is also known as opening tag. In opening tag, we use only angle brackets. Off tag is also known as closing tag. In this, we use a forward slash along with angle brackets. For example, body tag is a container tag. Empty elements. Empty elements contain only on tags. They do not have off tags. These elements do not contain any data. Instead, they work on their own. For example, BR tag. It has only opening tag. HTML document structure. The general structure of an HTML document has two sections, head and body. Head section. The head section contains general information about the document. It contains the text that define the header of the document. Body section. The body section contains the content that has to be displayed on the web page. It includes text, graphics, links, and other HTML elements that control and format a web page. Now you will see an HTML document structure. Whenever we start any coding, we must start with an HTML tag. You will see here head section and body section. Now you can see here that head and body sections are enclosed within head and body tags respectively. At last, we use closing tag of HTML to end the coding. Now we will learn about different types of tags which we use in HTML document. HTML tag. This tag identifies that it is a standard HTML document. You can see syntax on screen. It is a container tag. Head tag. The head tag defines the HTML document header. It is written just below the HTML tag, and it contains the document title, character set, styles, links, and script. It is also a container tag. Title tag. The title tag is used within the head tags. It contains the title of the web page, which will be displayed in the title bar. Title tag is also a container tag. Body tag. This tag contains the text which is displayed on the web page along with the other tags and attributes. Within this, we use formatting elements, images, headings, tables, hyperlinks, lists, etc. to make the web page look more attractive. Body tag is a container tag. Now, attributes of body tag. BG color. It is used to give background color to the web page. Background. It adds an image as a background. Text. It is used to change the color of the text. Link. This attribute specifies the color of the unvisited link. By default, color is blue. A link. This attribute specifies the color of the active link. By default, the color is red. V link. This attribute specifies the color of the visited link. The default color is purple. Top margin. It is used to set the top margin. Left margin. This attribute is used to set the left margin. Now let's do some coding. In this notepad, you can see an HTML coding by using BG color and text attribute. Always after using attribute name, we assign a value to it using an equal to sign. The value is always written within double quotes. As you can see, I have written BG color is equal to light blue, where light blue is written within double quotes. Similarly, I have used text attribute and assigned a value blue to it. One more thing, instead of writing color name, you can write color code also. Now let's see the result. In this web page, background color is light blue and color of the text is blue. As you can see, the text which was written within the body tags is being displayed here. Now let's do one more coding in which I have used background and text attribute of body tag. First, select any image from your device. After writing background attribute, make equal to sign. Then within double quotes, mention location of the image. Put a backslash. Next, write name of the image and then write extension of the image. After that, close double quotes. You can take all these location, name, and extension of the image from the properties of the image. In the same way, we can use other attributes of body tag. Let's see the created web page of the previous coding on the screen. An image as the background of the web page is being displayed here, and the text color is white. Here are some practice questions for you. What is HTML? What is the general structure of an HTML document? Differentiate between tags and attributes, container and empty tags. I hope you all enjoyed it and the basics of HTML got clear to you. The next video on HTML is on the way. Till then, goodbye and thank you.